Hey, what is up, everybody? This is Stephen Breach coming to you here today. Fun little morning story for you today. I wanted to make this video yesterday, but I went out to watch the Sacramento Kings play their home opener against the Los Angeles Clippers. We didn't get the win, but we showed a lot of heart, and we came way back. I believe at one point we were down by 15 points, and we came back to take the lead. Clippers locked it up with less than a minute to go, but the Kings should be a pretty good team, you know, to stand up to the Clippers like that. I'm proud of them. But story yesterday that was coming out was that Kurt Angle has signed a deal with Bellator, not to fight, but to appear at an upcoming fan expo where he's going to be taking pictures and signing autographs and kissing babies and everything like that. And also he's going to be appearing on his next show, where on the show he's going to be doing an interview and see where that leads from there. I think definitely the rumor that a lot of people are thinking that's going to happen is that Kurt Angle is going to be fighting Ken Shamrock on an upcoming Bellator fight. If Angle is able to get into shape, this is sort of like a lead-in to you know, him starting to work out and getting into shaped to actually do an MMA fight. Honestly, in my mind, for 1,000 different reasons, I believe this is not a good idea. Kurt Angle, which I believe is coming up upon 47, which is way older than CM Punk is to make his MMA debut. But honestly, if you think about Kurt Angle and his health status and everything that he's gone through in the last couple of years, Angle is one of the most physical wrestlers there is with his wrestling style. This is a guy who came into professional wrestling already with a broken neck, and all of the pressure and everything that he's put on his body. You know, just last year he had to take a sideline from TNA because of the fact they found glands inside of his neck that they thought were going to lead to being cancerous, and they took those out, and he was able to come back. He was able to have a match at Bound for Glory, but because after Bound for Glory they started using pre-shot televisions, he hasn't been on TV yet. And his contract's going to be coming up in the it's either at the end of this year or in the very beginning of next year, and he's said that he's not going to sign with TNA. He's not looking to sign with WWE. He is looking to go into something else, which a lot of people thought was going to be you know, trying his hand at movies or television and see what that leads to. Honestly, I can tell you this: if Kurt Angle goes into Bellator, win, lose, or draw, he already has a low shot of going into WWE. And I believe that a lot of people out there believe that they want to see Kurt Angle wrestle one last match for WWE, no matter what stage it's on. If he wrestles, you know, for NXT, and he becomes like a trainer at the Performance Center, and like he just goes into an angle where it's going to be on one of like the NXT, you know, pay-per-view sort of deals. You know, that'll be all right. If he wrestles at WrestleMania, you know, having a match against Triple H or something like that, and they want to do it on a big scale to, you know, really promote the fact that Kurt Angle is one of the best wrestlers of our era, I'm good with that too. But honestly, I believe that if Kurt Angle tries his hand at Bellator, and you can't go wrong. I mean, this has been a dream for Kurt Angle for a long time. There's been rumors that Angle was going to go on to The Ultimate Fighter. There was rumors that Angle was just going to sign a deal with UFC and get a fight that way. There was deals where Angle was going to go into Strikeforce. There's been thousands of different MMA rumors about Kurt Angle, and you can't blame the guy, because if this is the guy's dream, let him go do it. You know, Batista wanted to fight MMA, so he trained for years. He had a fight. He'll be the first to admit that, you know, the match wasn't good. It wasn't great. He'd probably say that he feels bad for anybody who goes back and watches it today. But, you know, if this is something that Kurt Angle wants to do because of how big of a fan he is, you can't knock the guy. You can only hope that he, you know, pulls through and does it. Ken Shamrock, you know, is a guy that's probably 20 years out of his prime. But with Bellator, you know, guys like him, Tito Ortiz, they're able to pull big ratings. Even Kimbo Slice, I think that was the last fight that Shamrock had was against Kimbo Slice. I remember watching it, and I just don't really remember the fight, who won, lost, or draw at all. But, you know, Bellator's pulled some big numbers. by having these guys come in. And definitely for Bellator, if you want to do a fight that's going to involve Kurt Angle and Ken Shamrock, I mean, that's definitely a way to pull in a great number of wrestling fans that don't normally watch your product because of that name value in what these guys meant to the WWE back in the day. It's going to be there, but I don't know if the fight's going to be any good. I'd pick Shamrock to take the win. There's no way I think that a 47-year-old Kurt Angle with no MMA, you know, experience is going to go in there and beat Ken Shamrock, a guy who's been doing this probably for 25 years and is always trained to be on top of the world. So we'll see what goes down with Bellator, Kurt Angle, and Ken Shamrock.